Sometimes questions are given like a graph basis, and that graph is between two scales. So sometimes they are asking to us find the relation between them. Now suppose that if I am taking example 30 degree and that is 180. This is a first temperature graph, and this is second, we'll say, and this is about suppose that 100 degree centigrade, and this difference is 150 where they are collide. Okay, and they are asking what is the relation between them. Okay, so look how we find the relation between them. So we'll take lowest of first one. Okay, so lowest of first one is what? We'll take general TA minus 30. TA is any general temperature. Okay, and the dead point where the both graphs are collide. So we'll take this, and this is at how much distance from it? Or we'll say highest of this 150 is equal to. Now if we see the lowest of TB, so the graph TB starts from 0, that is 0. So we write TB minus 0, and how much when it's collide with when 100 degree centigrade. So this is the relation between them. And further if we want to solve, so further it's 1, it's become 15, it's become TB by 10. Then again we can write TA minus 30 by 3 or TB. Okay, this is the relation. Okay, once again, first we'll take lowest one, and lowest one we'll subtract. So TA, this graph having lowest starts from the 30, so TA minus 30, and maximum is 30. What is the difference? 180 minus 30, that is 150. Similarly, lowest of this graph TB, when this graph starts, so 0, so TB minus 0, and highest is 100 degrees centigrade. Okay, now we'll see thermal expansion of matter. So when we see the thermal expansion of matter, so we'll talk about firstly length containing things, like length containing rod. Okay, means comparatively with the width they have more length. Okay, containing, suppose that if this is rod and initial rod is of L naught. So I just make you know, if suppose that this is 1 meter rod, this is 2 meter rod. If I am heating both of rod at the same temperature, which rod expand more, 1 meter or 2 meter? Definitely 2 meter rod expand more rather than 1 meter. Okay, so increment after T temperature, after T temperature, increment we'll say. Okay, so it's become, suppose that length become LT. So increment, that is this. So LT minus L naught directly proportional to L naught. Second, if I am taking both rod of 1 meter, okay, but in one I am changing temperature to 30 degree centigrade, another I am changing temperature to 80 degree centigrade. Which one elongate more, which one expand more? Definitely whose temperature changes more. So change in temperature, the expansion of length is also depend on the change in temperature. When we combine both of them, so LT minus L naught, it's become L naught del T. When we remove the proportionality, so here we have to apply the constant, that is linear coefficient of thermal expansion alpha, we'll say. Okay, that is L naught del T. Okay, so formula will come LT is equal to L naught, this side, alpha L naught del T. Del T is change in temperature, so LT is equal to L naught 1 plus alpha del T. Now So sometimes question will come too much directly from this. Sometimes they are asking percentage increase in the length. Percentage increase in the length. Okay. So percentage increase in the length, it's too much easy. Look, increment is what? LT minus L naught. Percentage increase means increment upon initial length into 100. They are asking for this. Okay. Now, so what I said, they are asking for LT minus L naught by L naught into 100. Okay. What is LT minus L naught? So look, LT minus L naught basically L naught alpha del T. Here we observe. So at the place of LT minus L naught, we can write L naught alpha del T. Here I am going to write L naught alpha del T by L naught into 100. So this will cancel out. So what is the percentage increase? Alpha del T into 100. Simple formula. Okay. There is no need of initial length. There is no need of final length if we know the linear coefficient of thermal expansion. Okay. And change in temperature. Alpha is what? Linear coefficient of thermal expansion. Now again, we'll see. If sometimes they are saying two rods of different length and different alpha. Okay, and they are saying like this, when we increase their temperature or decrease their temperature simultaneously, they both of them remains at the same length. Means their length is remain, or we'll say they are saying change in their length is remain same. Okay, the change in their length is remain same. So they are asking what is the relation between alpha 1 and L1, alpha 2 and L2. So look, it's too much easy. What is del L1? Del L1 is that is change, means they are asking LT1 minus L01. It means they are asking L naught means initial length. So initial length is L1 we have already taken. So L1 alpha 1 del T. Okay. This again I am saying del L1 is means increment in the length of L1. So increment is means at T temperature minus initial length from the formula this. You are writing L1 alpha 1 del T. Similarly, increment in del L1 is equal to increment in del L2. So I am writing LT2 minus. At all temperature, both are remain same. So I am saying L2 alpha 2 del T. At all temperatures, we are changing their temperatures simultaneously. So when we put both of them equal, because their increment is same. So what we're writing L1 alpha 1 del T is equal to L2 alpha 2 del T. So del T cancel out. So L1 alpha 1 is equal to L2 alpha 2. This is the relation between them. Okay. Now similarly thermal expansion we are seeing thermal expansion for area, areal expansion or superficial expansion we also say. Suppose that I have a sheet, so it has initial area we'll say A naught, okay, and after T temperature when I'm heating, so its area become AT. So everything is same. Increment in area is firstly directly proportional to initial area. Increment in area is also directly proportional to change in temperature. So when we combine both of them, then we are getting AT minus A naught directly proportional to A naught del T. AT minus A naught at the place of proportionality we are writing beta A naught del T. Okay, so A naught is going that side. AT minus A naught is equal to, sorry, again A naught del T. So this a naught is going that side. At is equal to a naught beta a naught del t. So at is equal to a naught, I am taking common, 1 plus beta del t. Okay, and this beta is called coefficient of superficial expansion or coefficient of aerial expansion, coefficient of aerial expansion or superficial expansion. Superficial expansion, and again, if somebody asks percentage increase or decrease in area, so like that, same we are writing beta del t into 100, direct formula. Okay, and if any sheets shows at the all temperatures same increment and decrement, so at that time the same relation will get a1 beta 1 is equal to a2 beta 2. Okay, similarly, this is the aerial expansion. Similarly, we'll see volumetric expansion. Suppose that any cube is given. And after T temperature, it has initial V naught. After T temperature, VT volume. So, what we write? Simply, as usual, VT minus V naught, increment in the volume is directly proportional to initial volume. VT minus V naught directly proportional to change in temperature. When we combine both of them, VT minus V naught directly proportional. Here we are getting volumetric expansion, coefficient of volumetric expansion, gamma, that is V naught del T. Same thing if we are getting at any temperature T, if we want to know the volume, so V naught is going that side, and this is become V naught, I am taking common, from 1 plus gamma del T. Okay, again, if somebody asks percentage increase or decrease, so it is gamma del T into 100. And same thing, if at the two cubes shows and to any type of two bodies shows at all temperatures same increment and decrement, so we'll say their relation gamma V1 is equal to gamma V2. Okay, now the question arises, sir, what is the relation between this alpha, beta and gamma? So it has small proofs. So I will do one, and similarly I will make another. Suppose that so quickly we'll do, okay, relation between alpha, beta and gamma, relation between alpha, beta and gamma. Suppose that I have a cube, I have a square. Firstly, I am going to find alpha and beta relation. Okay, so its initial length is a naught, but after T temperature its side length become at. Okay, so its initial area is a naught and final area is at. It is side length. What is the relation between length? At is equal to a naught 1 plus alpha del t. Okay, and what is the relation between areas? At is equal to a naught 1 plus beta del t. So this is equation, this one is equation first and this equation is second. Okay, what is a naught? A naught area is according to square, side square is the area, so a naught square. And what is at? At square. Okay, in first equation I am doing both side square. In first equation, when I am doing both side square, so it's become a naught square 1 plus 1 square plus alpha square del t square plus 2 alpha del t. This becomes 0. Why I am saying this become approximate 0? Because alpha value approximate 10 power minus 5. So its square become more or less, so it will seem 0. So at square, a naught square, 1 plus 2 alpha del t. Okay, now a naught is a naught square, at is at square. So at the place of at square we can write at, and at the place of a naught we can at the place of a naught square we can write a naught. So I'm going to put here. So it's become at and it's become a naught 1 plus 2 alpha del t. Now I'm going to compare above expression from second equation. Now what is the second equation? Second equation is this: at is equal to a naught 1 plus beta del t. Now when I'm going to compare this, so what I get the relation, beta is equal to 2 alpha. Okay, and same type of we are doing proof with the cube. We are taking initial for relation between alpha and gamma. So we are taking initial length a naught of one side, and after T temperature, this length become at. Okay, so initial volume V naught is a naught cube, and final volume Vt is at cube, and the relation between at and a naught is a naught 1 plus alpha t del t. So again we are doing same, and we are getting the relation gamma is equal to 3 alpha. Okay, so if somebody asks what is the relation between alpha, beta and gamma, so alpha is alpha, beta is the 2 alpha and gamma is 3 alpha. When we take the ratio, so alpha ratio, beta ratio, gamma ratio is equal to 1:2:3. Okay. Now students, see, this is the direct formula we'll use. What is the increment in the time of pendulum clock? Actually in pendulum clock, pendulum is like this way, which is oscillate. Okay. And give us time. But the thing is that during summer or winter time, it contract because it is of metal, or expand. So how much increment and decrement will come? So this formula will use directly. Okay. Now we are going to see calorimetry and principle of calorimetry. So first we'll see on which factor heat we'll say denote by Q. On which factor Q is depend. So first of all, Q is basically depend on the amount. Okay, just for making you know, if I am taking a small pen, okay, and a big pen, both I am providing heat and both of them having inside supposed water. So which wants more heat for reaching its boiling point, this one or this one? Actually this one. Why? Because amount of the substance here is more, so amount of heat required is Q is directly proportional to m. What is the amount? If amount is more, means mass is more, then needed of heat is more. Okay, it absorbs more heat. Similarly, if I am taking both pen are small and identical, okay, and both having same amount of suppose that water and whatever we have material, but one we boil to temperature 30 degrees centigrade, another will boil temperature 50 degrees centigrade, which will warm first and which will get more heat? Definitely of 50 degrees centigrade. Why? Because here change in temperature is more. Okay, so Q is also directly proportional to change in temperature. So when we combine both of them, so then we get m del t. But when we remove proportionality, then we use a constant, that is a specific heat constant, mc del t. Okay, this specific heat constant is different from material to material. Okay, now we are going to see the principle of calorimetry. What is the principle of calorimetry? In this calamity, we say that there is a neither loss of heat in due to radiation. Okay, means heat is not going into surrounding. Okay, this consideration will take. Okay, so according to this, heat gained by one body is equal to heat loss by another body. Okay, heat gain is equal to heat loss. Okay, means it's totally based on the conservation of energy. Conservation of energy. Taking in the consideration, there is no heat loss in the surrounding. Okay, now we'll see one of the example of this. Now suppose that 10 liter of hot water, that is at 70 degree centigrade, mixed with equal volume of cold water, that is at 20 degree centigrade. Find the resultant temperature. Okay, we have to find the resultant temperature. Okay, it's too much easy question. Okay, and a specific heat of water C is given, 4200 joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so now we'll see. So it will show, it is shown that hot water loses heat. Okay, so suppose that hot water after mixing with the cold water, the both are getting a temperature T. Okay, so what is the formula? Heat loss is equal to heat gain. Okay, so heat loss is how much? MC del T. So 10 liter water, that is water volume multiplied by supposed water density rho. M C of water, and del T is what? Hot water, if I am saying, so its temperature decreases, 70 minus T is equal to, now same volume of water means 10 into rho, mass is same, that thing is also water, that is C. Now its temperature rises. Okay, so its temperature rises means T minus 20. Okay, so final temperature is T, because it is a cold water, when mixed with the hot water its temperature rises. Okay, so this thing is cancelled out, and this becomes 70 minus T is equal to T minus 20, and this come on this side, it's become 90, and it's become 2T. T is equal to 45 degree centigrade. Okay, so final temperature is how much? 45 degree centigrade. Now one more topic we'll see, and that is real and apparent expansion. Suppose that I have a jar, okay, and this jar is lie over a surface, and I am providing heat. So initially the level of water is this. Okay, the initial level of water is this, what I said. Okay, now when I am providing heat, so initially heat is getting by the vessel. So we are assuming the vessel and that water both having same volume. Okay, so its first level of water or any liquid decrease. So how much decrement in the volume? So we'll say initially it is at level A, now it's coming to B. So decrement in the volume, so we'll say V naught gamma, decrement in the volume is equal to the increase in the volume of the vessel. So V naught gamma of, we'll say, vessel del T. Now after some time, when heat reaches to liquid its level rises to C. So B2 its level rises B to C. So this is the vessel expansion. Now what is the expansion of liquid? So we'll say V naught gamma, or real expansion of liquid into del T. Now, but if we observe initial point or final point, so what is the apparent expansion? So we'll say V naught gamma apparent into del T. Okay, so total increment, that is real, we'll take R. Okay, real increment. So del VR, that is real increment from B to C, that is of fluid or liquid. So that is vessel increment plus apparent increment, vessel increment and plus apparent increment. So what is the vessel increment? Del V. What is the apparent? Del V A. Now when we are putting this all values, so V naught gamma R, this value del T is equal to V naught gamma V del T plus V naught gamma A del T. V naught gamma A, these things are cancelled. So what is the relation between real expansion and apparent expansion? That is volume, vessel expansion and that apparent. Okay. Now further, you will revise the chapter from whatever you have source. Okay. And whatever I teach you in the previous lectures. And all the very best for tomorrow exam. Bye bye.